You know how important it is to have good quality footage to get good quality keying results, green screen, blue screen. In this video, I want to show you the impact of color compression on the keying process, so of the chroma subsampling. This means, are you working with raw footage or 4x4, 422, or worst case, H.264 encoded footage, depending on what level of color compression or chroma subsampling is happening, you have quite an impact on the keying, and I want to show you how that looks like, how you can analyze it, and how in some cases you can even mitigate it a little bit. This lesson is taken from my full compositing course, where I have two full chapters on keying with lots of discussion on pre-processing, impact of noise, how to do advanced keying processes for hair, and so on and so on. Feel free to have a look on my website for the full course, but first, enjoy this lesson. When we talk about color subsampling, we know that our human eye is very perceptive to changes in luminance, but not so perceptive to small changes in the color, in the chrominance, and that is what all compression codecs make use of. So if you have an H.264 codec or H.265 for online internet viewing, you have the luminance channel very accurate, but the chrominance is compressed, so you have four times the luminance information compared to each of the chrominance channels. And the same is being used in many camera codecs. If you record ProRes 422, you have for each four parts of luminance information, you have only two parts in each of the chrominance channels. And this may not be visible to our eye, but it is very visible to the keyer. So let's have a look at some example footage, see how it looks like, and I will also show you some trick what you can sometimes do to mitigate the issue a little bit if you do not have good chroma subsampling. Let's have a look. I'm looking here at this test footage, and on my screen I'm looking at it at full resolution. For you, I will have to zoom in a bit, and on the left side of my AB split view you see the ProRes HQ, and on the right side the H.264 encoding. Now, because this is again streamed for you as the training video, you get everything H.264 encoded, so whenever you cannot see exactly the differences I'm pointing out, I really recommend load it up on your own display, in your own machine, in your own Resolve installation. You have the footage, so just look at it offline. But if I zoom in and exaggerate a bit, you will see. And the first thing you will see is that here between the left and the right part, when I play this back, I hardly see a difference. Now, if I pay close attention, I see that here the hair is a little bit more blurry, and the more I zoom in, the more I will see the difference between the ProRes and the H.264. Again, H.264 on the right. You see it gets tiny little bit more blurry, but I really have to zoom in and pay very close attention to see that. Let me zoom in on an edge, and I zoom in really far to really see this. So I have here the shoulder edge. So let's just look at this, and you can hardly see a difference. What I can see is that the ProRes footage captures much more noise here, and if I look at the H.264, it looks almost like it's a bit denoised, but actually it's not really a denoise. It's more like it's getting more blocky, so it's not capturing this very fine level of noise from frame to frame. And that's not a big issue. I mean, artistically, of course, maybe I want to see it, but it won't be a big issue for the keyer. It might even be desirable, as we see in the next lesson. But all in all, just from looking at it, it looks pretty good, and I don't really see a difference if I just look at the edge, hardly any difference. But now let's see what this means to the keyer. So I will just add a delta keyer here, and I won't do like a complete keying run. I will just do very quickly sample the green here. And let's bring this on the left, and I bring the exact same delta keyer, just with an instance copy. I add it to the right from my H.264 image, and let's look directly at the alpha channel, and maybe I bring the gain up a bit, just tiny little bit, to get a bit rid of some of the background noise, and that's all I'm doing now. I'm not refining this, just to see the immediate difference between the two images. So I have left and right the delta keyer, both the same version of the keyer runs on the HQ ProRes footage, runs on H.264. And now let's have a look at the edge. So this is the edge from ProRes. And now I move over and my edge is completely ruined in the H.264. So something that was hardly noticeable in just looking at it with my human eyes in the full color image becomes very noticeable to the keyer. And you can look further if you look at the hair. So here we get some hair detail. And if I look at the H.264 image, the hair detail is basically gone. And so all in all, I really have a strong impact of my compression. So let me try to understand what's really happening here a little bit better by looking at the chrominance channels. And to do this, I want to look at an even more extreme example, because that increases again the chances that you can see that even here in the streaming recording. Again, try it yourself to see it on your own monitor without any additional encoding. So let me open an example here from Hollywood camera work back in the color channel. So I'm looking at this image here, and this image has also exposure issues and lots of issues, but it has a really terrible edge if I look at it, right? So let's see what's happening here. So one thing is, I mentioned that earlier, this edge, and I can use the gamma slider here maybe to see it even better. So this edge here, there's some artificial edge sharpening going on, some sharpening filter which makes the outside edge darker. But that's not the only thing. You also see these kind of steps, right? You see like steps going on like this. So let's start to analyze this further and look into the chrominance channels. And I can do this with the color space tool. Let me add a color space tool here. So the color space tool can transform my color image, if I set to color, from the current RGB into a YUV, which is the typical luminance, and then U and V are two chrominance channels. So this is the typical breakdown that is being used by most cameras and by encoding codecs like H.264. And if I just look at it, it looks ugly, of course. I don't see anything. But I can now go into these individual channels. And let's look into the luminance channel first, which is now in the red channel. So the first one are luminance. And this is what my edge looks like here. Okay, not as bad as in the full image, right? So I mean, it's not super resolution, but I do see an edge. It's a little bit blocky, but all in all, okay. So now let's go into the chrominance channel, into the green channel, the first one. Oh, what happened now? Now you see the same edge got much wider. So I had here the luminance and here the chrominance, and suddenly it looks like stretched. Do you see the edge is not as sharp here? It's spread out wider. And then in the second chrominance channel, the same. So again, luminance, first chrominance channel, second chrominance channel. So you really see that the edge is somehow has less resolution at the end. And here you even see like a spatial orientation of that issue. So depending on how your sensor pixels are arranged and how the encoding happens, you can actually sometimes really see the blockiness of the lower resolution. So you can see that in one orientation, it's only capturing like every second pixel compared to the luminance. So it's capturing this with less resolution, even though there may be some interpolation still going on from afterwards, but you can see these kind of steps in the image. Now in this case, there is actually something that we may be able to do. Now we cannot create information that isn't there, but at least we can smooth out some of the problems that we see here. So because we see these kind of steps which get a really bad edge, we can try to smooth them out a little bit. And what I do for this, I just add a blur node here after my color space, and I will blur those two chrominance channels a tiny little bit. So what I'm doing, let me bring in the blur. I don't want to blur in general, so let me first go to zero. So this is without blur. And then I want to do this. I'm fine with the luminance channels. I don't want to blur this, which is currently in the red channel. So I turn this off. Alpha doesn't matter. So I'm only looking at the two chrominance channels. And here you see I have resolution in the y direction, but in the x direction I'm having these jumps. Sorry, the other way around. So I need to blur in this direction, in the x direction, in order to avoid these kind of steps I see. So let me bring in a blur of one, and you see, I mean, I'm not getting a super clean edge now, but just by doing a one pixel step, you see, I can kind of avoid these extreme jumps that I'm seeing. Maybe even two, let's try. Yeah, so this way I'm getting slightly blurred, but it's not as zigzag as it was before. Let me also check in the other channel. So this was the blue channel, green channel, the other chrominance channel, with blur, without. So a 2 pixel blur in this case, just in this direction, and only on the chrominance channels, it makes those channels on the edge here a bit smoother at least. Let's see, I add the color space tool again at the end to go back, and now I'm going from color back to RGB, so I should go back to my original image here. Let me see in color view. Now let me have a quick look at before and after. So I still have my gamma slider down, by the way, just to make it very obvious. So this is the edge after my tiny little bit of blur in the chrominance, and this was the edge before. So I hope you agree, before, after. So I got rid of these like extreme strange artifacts. Now I'm not getting a great image from this. I still have issues with this footage, but at least I have mitigated this a little bit. And this will be very beneficial for the keyer. Let me very quickly demonstrate again with the delta keyer. I'll just bring the delta keyer in and again make an instant copy right away. Let's try directly here on the smooth edge. If I take the delta keyer here and key it alpha channel, let's have a look at it. Okay, and I'm just not even changing any settings. So this is my edge that I'm getting from my slightly blurred improved version. And this was my original edge. So you see, first edge, second edge. So this is definitely quite an improvement in this case. All right, hope this helps to understand the impact of chroma subsampling a bit better, and you can really see it and go into it. In some cases, like what I have shown here, in this extreme case, I was able to get a slight improvement on my keyer with a little bit of selective blur. I can't do magic. I cannot create information that wasn't there in the file, obviously. So these are like small tricks that can sometimes help, and that you can add to your tool arsenal. Thank you for watching this lesson from my compositing training course. This course builds strong foundations in the art and craft of compositing with Fusion. It covers topics from rotoscoping, keying, integration, 3D camera tracking, all the way up to topics like projection and multipass compositing. And it goes into a level of depth that very few online courses reach. If you're interested, check out the course page for further details, have a look what other students are saying about this course, and I'd be very happy to welcome you inside.